On July 7th, Chinese Premier Li Keqiang presided over an executive meeting of the State Council, during which Li talked about the difficulty of employment and again mentioned that China currently has more than 200 million flexibly employed workers. He said that these workers are not only working very hard, but also have no stability, and basic livelihood is not actually guaranteed. At the beginning of the year, according to mainland media Lookout Weekly, there is an increasingly larger group of people in flexible employment. The Ministry of Human Resources and Social Security show that, at present, flexible employment has become one of the main employment channels in China. Jobs like courier, housekeeping, ride-sharing, delivery, and others total up to 200 million people. Since the outbreak of the coronavirus, on the food delivery platform ELEME alone, 12,000 college students began taking up part-time delivery. The vehicle-for-hire company Didi also gained more than 1.5 million drivers in 8 months. At the closing press conference of the National People's Congress on March 11th this year, Li Keqiang responded to questions from the media on the issue of flexible employment. Li said, "The employment pressure this year is still very high. Urban labor force increased by about 14 million, including 9.09 million college graduates, a record high. Need to protect the employment of retired military personnel, but also to provide 270 to 80 million rural workers with job opportunities." He said that China's flexible employment is now on the rise, involving more than 200 million people, some of whom are working several jobs, which is very hard. Li Keqiang also said, "Our country's floating population has reached nearly 400 million people. According to the latest census data released by the Chinese government, 894 million people aged 15 to 59 are counted as the working population. If we exclude the students in school, almost half of them actually cannot find a living in their localities and have to go to other regions to find job opportunities. Among these nearly 400 million people on the move, more than 200 million can actually be considered as having flexible employment. However, these 200 million people cannot be included in the poor population of China because they are counted according to regions. So these people are not counted because they are working on the go outside their hometowns. Therefore, they can't even receive the small amount of poverty alleviation fund." On the eve of the two sessions in Beijing, the CCP officially announced that 98.99 million poor people in rural areas, 832 poor counties, and 128,000 poor villages in China had completely escaped from poverty. Xi Jinping also publicly declared that the nearly 100 million poor people in mainland China had achieved total poverty eradication, creating a miracle on earth. Premier Li Keqiang gave a speech about more than 200 million people being flexibly employed, which not only reveals the real situation of China's job market, but also refutes Xi Jinping's claim of complete poverty eradication, and punctures theory of economic internal circulation, which doesn't work at all. Observers believe that the CCP coined the term flexible employment in order to cover up the serious unemployment problem. Similar to replacing unemployment with layoffs, decline with negative growth, and fines with law enforcement, flexible employment is a euphemism coined by the CCP to refer to the state of not having a regular job and working odd jobs to make a living. In reality, the flexibly employed are not covered by pension and unemployment insurance, but are not really considered employed either. Unlike traditional employment methods, flexible employment is relatively free in terms of working hours, but unstable in terms of work, and should only be considered as a supplement to employment in other countries. However, due to its flexibility, short-term, mobility, and non-contractual nature, as well as the legal gaps in the new labor-employment relationship, workers suffer from unstable career prospects, unstable wages, difficult labor relationships, lack of social security, and difficulties in defending their rights when they suffer injustice. For example, there is a story of a 43-year-old ELEME delivery driver named Mr. Han. At the end of 2020, after delivering 33 orders and on the way to deliver the 34th, Mr. Han suddenly collapsed and died due to overexhaustion. After his death, his cell phone still rings from messages of late delivery penalties. The only protection he had was the $1.06 per day commercial accident insurance that he had purchased. Han's family contacted ELEME to fight for compensation, but was told that Han had no working relationship with ELEME. Out of humanitarianism, the latter provided 2,000 yuan, plus the 30,000 yuan from the insurance company, Han's family got a total of 32,000 yuan in compensation. Later on, after the public questioned the incident, ELEME announced they will provide a 600,000 yuan pension. So why couldn't Han get any actual compensation before this happened? Apparently, Han was registered as a driver through the Hummingbird crowdsourcing platform under ELEME and did not sign an actual labor contract. Therefore, since the labor relationship could not be identified, it was difficult to determine whether it was a work-related death, so Han could not receive compensation. This crowdsourcing platform has a lot of mystery surrounding it. Crowdsourcing is the practice of a company or organization outsourcing tasks previously performed by employees to the public on a voluntary basis. For example, in the case of crowdsourcing on a delivery platform, as long as workers register themselves and go through identity verification, they can become drivers and grab orders to earn money. In a sense, crowdsourcing is a business design of some employers, because there is no labor contract relationship and no need to pay various insurance premiums for workers, which can save huge costs and prevent labor disputes. Under the current situation, where the platform is becoming more and more prosperous, it's becoming one of the most favored models by many enterprises. For example, when Mr. Chen from Guangdong applied for a job as a delivery person for Meituan, he encountered such a requirement. The company asked him to sign an agreement to voluntarily give up his social insurance and other benefits during the work period. The company's owner claimed that not buying social security for the driver was a mutual agreement. Some researchers have calculated that, assuming the monthly social security contribution base for each flexible worker is 6,000 yuan per month, according to the basic insurance amount, the platform will bear 12% of it, or 720 yuan, which is 8,640 yuan a year. If the platform buys social security for each of the 3 million drivers, the annual social security expenditure will reach 25.92 billion yuan. Therefore, enterprises very much favor flexible employment. The Blue Book of China's Flexible Employment Development Report 2021, led by the School of Labor at Renmin University, shows that in 2020, the proportion of enterprises using flexible employment increased by more than 11% year-on-year to 55.68%. In order to reduce costs, some enterprises use various methods to avoid signing labor contracts with flexible workers, and also avoid the corresponding legal obligations. These methods include subcontracting, where a third-party company with little risk tolerance signs a non-labor contract with the laborer, such as a subcontract or cooperation agreement. Crowdsourcing, where flexible workers start work directly after registering on the platform, eliminating the need to sign contracts. Using an intermediary, where the company itself is separated from the laborer and signs a third-party agency contract with the laborer, avoiding direct employer responsibilities. Dispatching, where flexible workers are arranged to sign a labor contract with a labor dispatch company, changing direct employment to labor dispatch. For example, China's largest food delivery platform, Meituan, claims to have 10 million drivers, with about 4.9 million active. But even the purchase of a $3 business insurance has to be deducted from their pay. According to the company, they are all outsourced employees and have no direct labor relationship with Meituan. Not only that, because of the low requirements and flexibility of employment, delivery driving is one of the most seriously involuted industries in China. Involution and lying flat are popular internet buzzwords in China, used by the young population born in the 90s or 2000s, and they describe the living conditions of young people in modern China. Involution is originally a sociological concept that described the repetitive work of society and the lack of development opportunities. However, in recent years, involution is often used to describe the internal vicious competition. Some netizens describe it as extreme competition within a group to gain a small advantage. The result of the involution model is that it lowers the average earnings of the entire society. A delivery driver could earn 9 yuan for a delivery 2 years ago, but this year he can only get 4 yuan for a single order. And in order to compete with each other, drivers are willing to reduce their wages to get more orders. In China, delivery drivers can only earn the platform delivery fee, as customers do not have the habit of tipping. Not only that, but the delivery system is being optimized so that delivery times are getting shorter and shorter. Delivery time is the most important indicator in the setup of the delivery system, So going overtime is not allowed. And when it happens, it means bad reviews, lower income, and even termination. The result of this involution is that delivery drivers are working harder, resulting in greater traffic risks for everyone on the road. According to data, the average delivery time for orders across the industry in 2019 was 10 minutes less than 3 years ago. Some drivers have said that delivering is like a race to the death. And this would be true. Let us look at a set of data. In the first half of 2017, data from the Shanghai Public Security Bureau Traffic Police Headquarters showed that, on average, one delivery driver is killed or injured every 2.5 days in Shanghai. In the same year, 12 drivers were injured or killed in Shenzhen in 3 months. Looking at the data from 2018, an average of one driver is injured or killed every day in Chengdu for breaking the law. In September 2018, Guangzhou had nearly 2,000 traffic violations by delivery drivers, of which Meituan drivers accounted for half, and ELEME drivers came in second. This demand on delivery drivers has led to some new corporate successes. According to Meituan's 2020 financial statements, Meituan's annual revenue was $114.8 billion. According to China's new Fortune 100, Wang Xing, the owner of Meituan, is worth about $180 billion. So why are there so many flexible workers in China? First, due to the withdrawal of foreign enterprises, many quality jobs have disappeared, and a large number of employees who were working in foreign enterprises have lost their jobs and became flexible workers. Secondly, China's internal circulation economic policy and the sharp increase in the price of raw materials have caused a large number of enterprises to struggle to survive or even go bankrupt, resulting in the dismissal of employees or a drop in their income. This has also led to an influx of people into flexible employment. Thirdly, governments at all levels do not assume the responsibility of providing basic assistance to the unemployed population, nor do they have corresponding relief measures. For example, during the epidemic, many governments issued economic stimulus programs and bailouts, but China has not seen a single bailout policy for the unemployed. In order to survive, people have to rely on jobs such as delivery drivers, which has relatively low requirements and can earn a decent income as long as they are not afraid of hard work. Fourthly, many young people prefer this flexible mode of employment with more free time compared to the traditional manufacturing or construction industry. For many young people who choose to lie flat, this flexible employment may be more suitable for their way of life.